Ready.
Heath Martin is Tangipahoa's chief jailer, the warden at the parish jail, and he joins us here at the Italian Festival Spaghetti Cook-Off in Tickfaw. You're also a candidate for sheriff, which is, I'm sure, what you want to talk about. But first, how's everything going at the jail?
Well, we are starting our second phase of replacing the locks and hinges on some of the doors. The company that came in and was doing that work for us, they run out of materials. Apparently, something may have happened with some type of container off the coast from China or something along that lines. I don't know. But they're back to work at it, and they're making sure that we're getting those things changed, because what they've done for us so far has been so effective for us, and they've been our able to maintain control of those offenders. It's really helped.
Well, the other candidates for sheriff, I mean, they all mentioned the jail, but what in particular can you do with the facility that clearly the building should have been replaced a while back, and there's just not money to do what really needs to be done, or so we've been told?
Well, the number one thing is I believe we need to develop a partnership. We need to get our governmental agencies together, working together for a common goal. You know, there's grants out there that we can approach. There's many things that we can do if we come together and with a collective mindset, a progressive mindset. We can find ways to make this happen. I am certain of it.
Well, let's turn to the campaign. For example, you were at this event all day today. What are you hearing?
Well, this has really picked up pace, and it's very exciting, and it's also humbling as well, because, you know, the outpouring of support from so many people, that a lot of people I hadn't seen in so many years, and then again, some people that I've worked at law enforcement for. You know, they were victims of crime, and I helped them with their most tragic moments, and they've come out, and they're showing their support, and it's really picking up steam, and I like it. I really do.
One thing I'm noticing now is I'm meeting more and more people who are your relatives. It's just that you've sort of activated the family ties, and thankfully you'll be happy to hear that they're all for you.
And that's a good thing. That's really a good thing. You know, we have a lot of law enforcement in our family, and you know, my family, they're really politically active people. My mother, for instance, she is just a tremendous person that she's always been involved with something. She was involved with our high school boosters club, and I was still in elementary school, and she would say this, you know, one day you will be here, and I want you to have the best. So, you know, it's that mindset that was instilled in me by her, is that, you know, you're not just working for today, you're working for tomorrow, and that's a very important thing for us.
Well, you know, looking at it as a horse race, you're facing a lot of competition. All the candidates so far, I mean, they're some top-flight people in politics. But then again, I mean, you've got just a plethora of candidates, just the sheer number. It might only take 20% of the vote to make the runoff.
Isn't this amazing? You know, but what I want to do, I want to have the community really come out. I want the community to get involved in this process. I want you to learn your candidates. Look into it. Don't just vote for somebody because they're the first one come to your door. You would never, ever buy a first car you set in, ever. And the way I look at it like this is, you know, if let's say I have an electrical problem, I'm not going to go find a plumber to take care of my electrical issue. I say, if you want a lawman to be the chief law enforcement officer of the parish, why don't you find yourself a lawman? Look into those resumes and see actually who has been doing the job and knows how to do the job and has been here in Tangipahoa Parish for his career.
You know, yeah, I know you would say that you've got a very varied law enforcement resume. Yeah. Yes, you're the warden now, yeah. But you've come up through all kinds of enforcement.
Man, my wheelhouse has always been investigations. You know, I'm a certified homicide investigator. I'm an instructor for various less lethal weapons. I'm an active shooter instructor. You know, my credentials go on and on. You know, teaching, I'm a 21st Judicial District expert witness on narcotics up there. You know, I've taught Baton Rouge Area Mutual Aid about clandestine labs. Yeah, my credentials go on, and my wheelhouse is certainly in enforcement.
If you had a specialty, wouldn't it be drugs?
Well, drugs is a prevalent problem, and that's something that we need to take a. My approach to law enforcement has always been preventative, proactive. If we can stop those crimes from happening, then we're winning. enforcing the law is an easy thing. Putting somebody in jail, writing up those booking charges, and that's the easy thing. But if we can prevent that from happening where we don't have to enforce law, then we're winning.
Well, the coroner's office in St. Tammany has done something that I really wish our coroner's office would do here, namely publicizing the fentanyl deaths.
Amen.
And what he has shown is, and this brings it home to people, on a statistical basis, every day there's a fentanyl death in St. Tammany Parish. I do death notices for a living on our website, and I see the pictures of these younger people who are dying, and you know it's a drug overdose.
Amen. Absolutely, Ken. You know, that's one of my biggest things, accountability and transparency. The people need to know what we're struggling with, because I want community investment. I want our community to be invested with us, because me as a leader, as your sheriff, we're going to be invested in our community, and we need to have that out there where we're struggling with. That way we can get the support that we need to combat this.
You know, they're drugs, but then they're drugs.
Yes.
Nobody's going to die from smoking marijuana. That might cause you health problems or lack of productivity or a car wreck, whatever. But fentanyl is so toxic, it kills. It's probably the most lethal recreational drug, if you can use that term, we've ever seen.
So how's about this? You know, we've always been in law enforcement, issued things to protect ourselves, like our weapon and our spray and our nightsticks and things like that. But now we're being issued Narcan to protect ourselves, because at any given time, we could end up being overdosed during a traffic stop or through an arrest type incident. This stuff is lethal. I believe that there should be higher penalties for this. You know, we had an issue with heroin back in, what was it, in the 70s, and we had to harshen those penalties for that crime to get it to stop, because it was killing people then. I say we as a community need to get with our legislators and say, hey, look, enough is enough. It's time that our families stop dying. But me as a law enforcement officer, when I'm elected and that bell tolls midnight and I take office July the 1st, 2024, we are going to set precedents that Tangipahoa Parish will not tolerate drugs or drug dealing in this parish. We are going to set the tone that if you're going to deal this poison in his around, you're going to deal it somewhere outside these judicial districts, because we're going to constantly push this until it's gone.
What's next in your campaign?
Well, you know, the day started off, we had certifications with Mounted. You know, I've been active with Mounted, and it's good to see those guys and girls up there. They work so hard. And I'd like to see that division expanded. In fact, in part of my plan, I'm going to create a special operation division, SOD division, where our specialized trained individuals will be housed underneath that umbrella, and they will be basically the best of the best. And those resources like that could be used. They're multifaceted, you know. Not only are they good for publicity, but they're good in you know, search and rescues. And if there happen to be an escape at the jail, they're there for that. Our ball games, they're there to interact with our people at the ball games to ensure safety and security. You know, so it's good to get there and see those guys working and just what they do. It's amazing. The public ought to get involved. People should get involved with their law enforcement, yes. But, you know, later on today, on the way back, I had spoke to some people at a church. I called them, and I have a testimony that I tell everybody that occurred to me when I was in that explosion. And that testimony is that there's power in prayer and that God is real and that there's a better place. And I try to share that every chance I get. So I met with those people, and on the way down from there, I put up a sign. Here I am at the Italian spaghetti cook-off. And, you know, so many great people here. So much food here. I have exercised great restraint from not indulging in so much of good food. But after this, I have to go to a meet and greet where there's a bunch of people are going to be there. It is nonstop. And then come Monday morning, I got to be right back at the grind as being a full-time deputy sheriff for the Tangipahoa Parish Sheriff's Office and the community and the people of Tangipahoa Parish.